On the Morning Groove this morning, we got some phenomenal brothers making strides. And you know what? Their dads are famous. You know what I'm saying? It's hard kind of, you know, living in that shadow, trying to get out of that shadow. But the brothers are making strides in that direction in their own right from growing up hip-hop New York. JoJo Simmons and Lil ODB. Welcome to the Morning Groove, gentlemen. How you doing this morning?
I'm all right. You know, I already know. You said my name wrong, though.
It's
YDB.
Yeah.
But they understand, though.
They know. Well, you know.
What I'm saying?
We know.
Hopefully the universe catch on quick.
They should know. Yeah. They should know. But welcome to the group, first and foremost.
Bless you.
Secondly, man, you guys are kind of like doing your own thing right now.
Yeah.
And trying to, like I said, get out of the shadow of, you know, what your dad's built, which in both cases was phenomenal.
Thank you.
So I'll start with you. Like, how does it feel like just trying to navigate that? And I see you got the merch already. You're doing your own thing.
Yeah, I'm definitely I'm not trying to get out of no shadow.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Peter Pan, that's his problem.
That's his thing.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's right.
But me, I'm trying to continue a legacy.
Right.
Because he's not here no more. So, of course, I got my merchandise. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Got my T-shirts at Route 21. I got the mugs on Amazon.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But it's bigger than that. You know what I'm saying? This is about hip hop.
Yeah.
It's the continuation. If you ain't doing nothing but sitting on your couch, at least listen to us.
Right.
We're here to give y'all that message.
Right. Yeah. JoJo.
What's up?
A little bit about, you know, just being, you know, from the bloodline,
mm-hmm.
and just trying to navigate where, you know, people focus on JoJo, not so much on.
You know, I had to learn throughout the years to separate it but still use your resources in the right way. You know what I'm saying? So
yeah.
I used to want to grow up and be like, man, I don't want nobody to know my father helped me or anybody, because I wanted to do it on my own, which is a good thing. But
right.
I think you also need to use those resources to get where you need to go and do what you got to do, but do it in your own way to build your own legacy. So I don't really feel like I have to, like he said, ain't no shadow, I don't got to do none of that.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to be us, and we're going to create our legacy, because when it's all said and done, our kids got to look up to us. Not their grandparents, they got to be their father that created their own legacy. So that's how I look at it. I don't really look at it as pressure or anything, because I have no pressure. I'm happy in my skin, and I'm happy in how I move,
dope.
And I'm happy in how I take care of my family. As long as I'm doing that,
yeah.
I don't need to be like Reverend Run. I need to be like JoJo. You know
yeah,
what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I need to be the best version of me. You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
But speaking of that continuation, oh my gosh, One Music Fest, which happened almost a couple of months ago, and you've been performing with Wu-Tang.
All praises due.
Oh my goodness. This guy right here is a show stealer. Like when he comes out and he represents.
I don't do it on purpose, though.
Look.
You do it on the growing up hip hop, too.
No, see.
He's a show stealer.
He is a show stealer. I was like, if this is not young, dirty bastard, he is his pops, and that energy and that voice and just so charismatic. I mean, the talent is just in your veins. And I just want to commend you, because I was like, this kid and came out here and stole the whole show.
Seriously. Hold your own.
Yeah, with those.
With those cats.
Yes.
That's
yes.
heavy. That's about as heavy as it gets.
Oh, my gosh.
No, I started at 19, but it took a time, a grace period to practice.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it wasn't, I ain't just get it like tomorrow. You
right.
know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It was definitely practice.
Looks like
just
he
like
got
a ballerina.
Yeah.
Starts off
yeah.
young and, you know, just.
Man.
Yeah.
What's something that you learned out the industry that your parents didn't share? Something they went through, but you had to learn it on your own. They didn't even tell you this was coming.
The deep, long contracts.
Yeah. Yes. Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Definitely something nobody talked to about.
Deep and long.
You'll be trapped in until the infinity.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's
yeah,
no getting out.
I agree. The business side of it, the paperwork. You know what I'm saying? Because I got a label right now, and I like to sign artists, develop artists, but it's like, you be having so much fun, and you just having fun, and then the paperwork comes in, the contracts mm-hmm. coming in. Nobody taught you that. Everybody wants to get paid, obviously, but you got to do paperwork, and you know what I'm saying. Sure. It could blur the lines with people and friends. So I get exactly what he's saying. I agree. I think that the paperwork and the contracts and all this other stuff, nobody ever taught us that. We just thought, all right, be famous, do your thing, make some money. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Nah, but you got it's so much more than that.
Did y'all have any incident that made you say, "Oh, whoa, I need to start studying the paperwork more"? Was there a moment that something happened?
Yeah, it was a few. When we signed with certain lawyers after my father passed in 2004, the lawyers gave us bad direction, and they were robbing the East State. So it was like, how do we get out of this one? You know what I'm saying? Because your lawyer's supposed to guide you.
Right.
Yeah.
So it was deep, real deep. So we was like, okay, now we got to really go into the scriptures.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. You know? The business side of it. Yeah. And it's funny because speaking of parents, your mom is here in the studio. So do you guys have a business relationship? Is it?
That's our only relationship. Yeah. I'm playing around. No, that's my mom. I love my mama.
That was so cute. He's like, mommy, you know, it's just the cutest thing. So is she like your manager or just here supporting?
She's the administrator of the Russell Jones Estate.
Love it. Love it. Yeah. Love it.
Basically, she here watching every word come out of his mouth.
Make sure he handles his business. Exactly. Mom got you on those
push
deep
the product, baby.
Now.
Push the product.
Some people, she remind them of Cookie. She, you know, Cookie.
Cookie Lions.
I like that. You say that? I like that, though.
He just called his mama Cookie Lions.
She right. Don't play. That's what that means.
She a boss.
So tell us a little bit about growing up hip-hop, and what can we expect out of Young Dirty Bastards' plot this season?
There's no plot.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's just the as real as you can take it.
Storyline.
And as far as you can take it, it's carrying on a legacy, which is through the babies.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I'm preserving our, you know, future.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And guiding us the right way, JoJo.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. As he tosses it to JoJo,
For you, like, what is the storyline? You know, what hurdles do you have to jump over this year?
I mean, what I'm going to say. I'm going to say watch the show. But little things, because on the last, on Grown Up Hip Hop LA, I got engaged. So obviously you'll see me trying to work on getting married and me trying to have more children and just little stuff like that. I don't want to give everything away, but you're going to definitely see me and my family a lot more. Me, my fiance, and my daughter a lot more in this Grown Up Hip Hop New York.
Dude, like, you're still a little JoJo to me.
I'm 30 years old.
I know,
like,
but
I'm grown
man. I'm such a big fan of Pops and watching y'all show you know, watching you grow up during that time.
Yeah,
he's still a little JoJo to me. Married, and, you know.
I know, right? It happens fast.
Right.
You think watching them on the show is like they're all just grown. Him and his sisters, everybody's just, and your other little brother, everybody's
you can
just
say
grown
his name,
now.
Diggy.
Yeah. Everybody's just grown now. Whole crew. It blows my mind. But I got to ask you guys, because you're two, of course, your fathers are iconic in the hip hop game. These lists have been floating around. In your minds, and feel free to add yourselves to it if you want to, but if you could name your top five, I'll even give you seven, top seven rappers ever, who would that be?
Well, my first is my father, ODB.
Absolutely.
Because I wouldn't be here without him. And my second is Papoose.
Wow.
You know?
So that's dope.
Yeah, my third,
The
businessman, Jay-Z.
Okay.
And my fourth, I got to give it to RZA.
Yes.
And my fifth, that's a big one.
Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't even have a fifth. I go Elvis Presley.
Okay, I like that. Curve. What about you, JoJo?
Do I have to put him in an order, or I could just name him? I don't really have an order.
You don't have to put him in
an
order.
All right, so I'm definitely going to go with Biggie, Jay-Z, Nas, Eminem, Fabulous. What is that, four or five right there?
That's four.
This is where it gets sticky right here.
Sticky fingers?
No.
He's
like,
nah.
This is where like I gotta remember like who I really listening to.
Yeah.
And who do I really enjoy? I probably have to go with somebody like that's a good question. This is my fifth I'm going for right now. Mm-hmm. So I said Biggie, Nas, Jay-Z,
Eminem
and Fab. That is five.
That is five?
Yeah,
you did say five.
And then six, Jadakiss.
Okay.
And then seven.
It's a good list.
That is a good list.
Yeah, that's why it's so hard for me because I really love this rap shit. Like, excuse my language. Seven.
You know, you can let it go.
Seven.
Grown man.
It's rap here.
Dang, it's so because there's so many people that I would put in that. There's like this Lil Wayne, this T.I., this Big Pun. There's so many people I could put. I probably have to go with Lil Wayne.
Nice.
Okay. What's weird about your list is a lot of people don't put Eminem
on the list.
On their list.
You're crazy if you don't.
I agree, but he never really makes anybody's list.
Yeah, no, he's got to make the list. Mm. Eminem has to make your top five every time.
I'm with you.
You feel me?
Lord Jamar, you know, he just had a little conversation on some Eminem business saying he wasn't a part of, he said black people don't bump M in the hood.
That's a lie.
It's a lie. The thing is, you're not going to get in your car and throw on Eminem and be riding out to some swag because he doesn't do that. Right. Mm-hmm. But he makes you think, and he has lyrics, and he plays with words.
For days.
So me, I'm a fan of rappers.
Bars.
He's a bar rapper. He's a spitter. He got on a record with Jay-Z and said, look what I'm going to do.
And was like,
and he got a record with all these greats. And he said, look what I'm going to do. You know what I'm saying? So, like I said, I mean, I think that Eminem is amazing, and he's always going to be in my top five. If we doing top 10, I got other people. Like I just love a lot. I like some of the new people, too. I think Kendrick is dope. I think J. Cole is dope. I think Drake is dope.
Yeah.
I think a lot of these people are dope.
Yeah.
But I grew up on that time and that era of the people I just named.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Which are the people between the two of y'all that y'all both named that if they called you and said, come record, you'd be like,
Jay-Z.
Jay-Z.
Yeah.
Or Fab.
Yeah.
Fabulous has always been my favorite rapper of all time.
No, because Jay-Z, he dealing with the football. Mm-hmm. You know, all praise is due to him on that. I don't know what other people think, but I think that's a righteous move. Especially for us.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely facts. Puts us at the table, that's for sure.
Jay-Z definitely he's somebody good to look up to and to be like, yo, I want to move that way. I want to do things that way. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, I rocks with Ho for sure. Yeah. If he calls me, I'm leaving this interview right now.
That's right.
Your uncle's not a bad person either.
Oh, but he's not a rapper, though. You know what I'm saying? I can't put him in that list. If we talk about top five businessmen, he's going to be number one.
There you go. Best piece of advice that you ever got from your dad.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I've said this on the show on Run's House before, but this is my favorite advice, and I say this to everybody. Don't let your happenings destroy your happiness.
Mm-hmm.
You feel what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So that means no matter what's going on around you, what's going on in life, don't let that mess up your mood and your vibe. You know what I'm saying? Don't let stuff around you, because energy is a huge thing out here in this world. You give off that bad energy, you get that back. So you guys stay giving off positive energy and positive things will come back to you. I learned that in life that I was missing for a little bit. But then when I started looking at life a different way and being more positive and giving instead of wanting to receive, is when everything fell into place.
That's when the blessings began to flow.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Young Dirty.
Yeah, so, you know, as you're saying, good direction.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The best information you could give is to take care of your moms, first of all. Mm-hmm. And that's what I do. I help out, like, every day. And your children. And your cousins.
Yeah.
Cousins is headaches.
Take care of your family. Take care of your family.
Major headaches.
But take care of your cousins.
Take care of your family. unless it's the cousin that'd be like, I'm your cousin. And
you were really your cousin,
since they was like, I seen you since she was knee high. Yeah, all right.
Yeah.
I ain't got no money for you, brother.
It'd be
like that. Yeah.
Cousins are headaches.
So with the Wu-Tang series, what are your thoughts on that right now?
True thoughts?
Yeah, true thoughts.
Political thoughts?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, boy.
Well, you know, I didn't get accepted on a TV show.
Which I didn't understand.
Because they got somebody who had some experience.
Mm-hmm. In acting?
Yeah, and some experience in acting. And I was more qualified, I think, in performing as my father. And I mm-hmm. know it the best.
Right.
And I think the people who was actually heading the show, mm-hmm. taking, you know, the leaders of the show, they knew
mm-hmm.
that.
Mm-hmm.
And that they didn't give me that. I feel like that was more political.
Yeah.
I mean, keep it real with you.
Appreciate the realness. Because I just thought, like, how do you not, and especially after seeing you perform,
too.
I was like, how do you not cast this kid as his pops?
To keep it real, you know? Somebody saw the show and they thought it was him. And I was like, that's not YDB.
No.
Yeah.
It's just a lookalike for now.
That's crazy.
I mean, I'm not hating on the guy. He got a job and he's acting, but I'm saying, I think the whole world would have wanted to see him play.
Absolutely.
His father.
Yeah. Maybe there was a little fear that you might shine a little bit too bright in this.
Well, you know, like you see me on the stage, that's all I got to say.
Yeah.
Any stage is welcomed.
Look,
it's all our home.
I don't think y'all understand out there. That's a must-see.
I can't hear you, mama.
I mean, powerful.
Oh, yeah. Okay, the truth is,
what
people don't know about my pops is that he was a natural-born leader.
Mm-hmm.
And in front of the Wu-Tang, I mean, they were all family.
Yeah.
But he stood out because he had that voice and that power just to keep himself humble, but also feel his frequency from a long, faraway distance.
Mm.
And you go Star Wars with that.
And you have all that. That's what's so
powerful
about it.
We all do.
Yeah.
It wouldn't be no me without you.
Yeah, you're right.
YDB, please, man, I'm dying to know. Tell me how you feel about the holograms being used for those of our entertainers that aren't here. They about to start the Whitney tour with it. I saw it with your dad. Do you think that's something that they should do, or do they just leave it be?
Well, the hologram, think about it. I didn't like it before because it was about business. And, you know, if you taking people's money that way and not giving it to the family, because a legacy without that man not being here, or that Whitney Houston not being here, what's the point of doing it if you're not giving it back to the family?
Mm-hmm. Right.
But as far as a hologram, I seen Star Wars. You seen Star Wars. It was cool. And you get to leave something big. She's still, come on, I wish I could die and a hologram of me still be there in the children's classroom teaching. On that level.
Yeah.
You know?
So, YDB, what's next? I mean, like, you always working on something.
Yeah.
Obviously.
Yeah.
But, you know, what do you see happening next?
Yeah, next, November 15th. Yeah. Mm-hmm. You know? That's my father's tribute. Mm-hmm. And that's the biggest thing because I'm dropping my song dedicated to me.
Right.
You know, I was born for a reason too.
Right.
My real name is Bar Sun.
Yeah.
You know, so I'm dropping my track. It's like real lyrics, you know? Mm-hmm. Something, you know, the game has been missing.
And that's November 15th, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. What about you, JoJo?
What's the question?
What you got coming up next?
On?
Yeah. I mean, got your hands in.
I'm on Grown Up Hip Hop LA is about to come back on, so I'm on that. I'm working on this label. I've been building this label for a few years now, just trying to get it off the ground, Cahoots House Entertainment, where I'm developing artists, writers, and producers. I got this Daddy Committee brand that I'm just pushing to, you know, all dads out here. It's not just a clothing. It's more of a lifestyle thing for dads, you know what I'm saying? Anybody that's, you know, I just try to push the narrative that being a dad is the coolest job in the world.
It is.
You know what I'm saying? And a lot of guys don't realize that and stray away from being a dad, or maybe they have a problem with, the mother or whatever the case may be. But my whole thing is, take care of your kids and be a good dad. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I think a mom is very important for the nurturing, but a dad is there for the lessons and the teachings. You know what I'm saying? So I feel like dads should definitely, all dads should be in their kids' lives. And that's why I'm pushing the narrative of Daddy Committee.
That's dope. For those out there that see you guys through the lens of your pops, because I know you have a fan base that actually know you, but then those are the people that actually see you through the lens of Old Dirty, see you through the lens of Rev Run. Yep. What would you want that fan to know about you?
Well, I want that fan to know that we exist for a reason.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know,
I like that.
And somebody told me they were proud of us. And I was like, why? You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Are you proud of yourself? First thing, proud of yourself.
Yeah.
And then I was like, okay. She said, there's a path. Some people has a path and some people got a destiny. And we see y'all going to wherever y'all supposed to go in life, and it's beautiful. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Seeing that being passed down like that.
Yeah.
And y'all carrying those torches.
Yeah.
You know?
That's deep.
That's high.
I agree. Yeah. I honestly agree. Like you said, we're here for a reason. We wouldn't be here. We wouldn't be in this position, obviously, if it wasn't for our parents. So that's why people are going to look at us through that lens. But watch us and see how we move. We not them. We are us. You know what I'm saying? And see that we're not just trying to be them. We're trying to be us.
Yeah.
I love it. I love it. We're about out of time, but I just wanted you to plug your merchandise one more time where they can.
Oh,
since
you're doing that.
Yeah.
Well, I got an organic beer coming out for the people who like to party sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, watch out for the babies. Mm-hmm. But it's called Young Dirty Brew. You know,
okay. I like that.
Yeah,
you know, that's dope.
The honey is also from Staten Island in Brooklyn. Mm-hmm. That's going to be mixed in the brew.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we got merchandise here.
Yeah.
On Rue 21. Go get your T-shirts and your coffee mugs at Amazon.
I'm liking this. Like,
That's mom chiming in.
Mom is making sure he gets everything.
First of all, I got to give a big shout out to SOBs. Mm-hmm. You know, they've been doing their thing, holding down that. And we're having a big traditional party. And, you know, for November 15th. Yeah. November 15th.
November 15th.
And catch me at Young Dirty Bastard Instagram.
Love it.
Yeah.
Don't forget Growing Up Hip Hop New York. Don't forget that.
Thursday.
These cats are killing it right now.
That's why
we're
here. Growing Up Hip Hop New York.
That's it.